Hi, welcome back to the GM Academy. Of course, I'm your instructor, Jim McClure, and this is our 101 class on our brand new topic, which is designing villains. Now, this is a very large topic. There's going to be quite a few classes on this because really there's a lot to it. Villains, to a large degree, are the backbone of story. They're the backbone of the interesting thing that's going on. They are very important to so much of what we do at a tabletop, and of course, making that classic villain, that one that the PCs just hate so much and just really want to bring down, it's a very important aspect, and there's really a lot to it. So, starting off with this 101 class, the first thing that we need to discuss is the purpose and types of villains that are out there. And this is, again, just to give us our base understanding before we start getting more into the nuts and bolts of what goes into making a good villain. The purpose of a villain. Again, it seems like it should be fairly obvious, but the purpose of a villain, everything that you do when you're designing your villain, is to make it so that they directly oppose the PCs. They are the antagonist to the PCs who are the protagonist. And I want to just go ahead and get this out there because it's going to happen a lot in the series. I'm going to interchangeably use villain and antagonist. Technically, they are not the same thing. There are differences. But for the sake of simplicity of these videos, I'm going to use villain and antagonist interchangeably. But the purpose of the villain is to directly oppose the PCs and give them an obstacle to overcome. That's why you make the villain. And I want it to be very clear. The villain is there to make the PC story more interesting. The PCs are not there to play the villain's story. And that's very, very important, especially starting out, because some people really do get that backwards and create this. And it's not even always intentional. I've made this mistake myself. I made this awesome world. I make this awesome villain. I love him. He's interesting. He's engaging. He has all this wonderful stuff. And now it's the PC's turn to learn about my villain and what my villain is doing in the world and this and that. And it can be fun. But normally it's not, because what the PCs need is a villain to their story. The protagonist, it's their story. Their story needs an antagonist. We don't have an antagonist that needs protagonist for his story. So, again, it's an important distinction, but a very specific one and very important one to make. So, once we know, of course, what our the purpose of our villain is, which is to make the PC story more interesting, then we look at, there's really three main types of villains that we are going to see within tabletop. And that is our intelligent, our unintelligent, and our force. Now, I'll sort of break these down. An intelligent villain is a villain that has, I mean, clearly intelligent, but has a plan, has a moral code. I mean, some people in D&D might even call this a lawful evil character, but it is that they are an intelligent thinking being that has a plan that they want to achieve. That is an intelligent villain. An unintelligent villain is your, you know, these are often used for like boss fights. These are your unthinking monster. Your, it wants to go eat the town because the monster eats people. That is an unintelligent villain. It can be, you know, still a very good villain. You can build up to them. Intelligence are not the only villains out there, but an unintelligent villain is essentially just acting on baser instincts or acting without, you know, a semblance of intelligence or a plan. They just, you know, the unintelligent type of dragon that's guarding its hoard. It's going to sit on its hoard of treasure, it's going to go out and get more treasure, and it's going to kill anyone who tries to take its treasure. Now, it's not actively looking to kill anyone, it's not actively looking to make the world better, it just wants a bigger pile of gold to sit on. That is an unintelligent villain. Now, a force is something that's completely different from either of the two. A force is essentially a villain that's not necessarily one specific thing, but a circumstance or a group of things to overcome. So think of an assassin's guild without a leader, that each act individually. Now, a hit's been put out on your PCs, the assassin's guild is now this force that objectively opposes the PCs. They can't negotiate with it. There's no headquarters to go storm. There's no, you know, leader to go kill. If there was a leader who was directing them, then you'd have an intelligent villain and minions. But this is just a force. It is a group of people that they have to, whenever they interact with the force, they have to fight it. They have to handle it as a unit. Now, the other thing is environmental forces. You know, perhaps your villain is not even so much directly a villain as it is the PCs have set up and established this town, and now we have drought. Now we have the river has run dry, whatever the case may be, and they are literally fighting the elements themselves. This also applies quite frequently when we are talking about a survival situation, you know, a post-apocalyptic type game, or just survival out in the desert, where it's the forces of nature themselves which are acting as the antagonist. They are acting as the foil to the PCs. So, those are our main three types of villains. And again, just to reiterate, a villain's purpose is to make the PC story more interesting. And these are our main three type of villains. So, everything that we build on, we're going to look at how does this type of villain make the PC story more interesting? What can we do to make this type of villain make the PC story more interesting? And everything's going to build from that. So, that's been our 101 class on villains. As we go through this, we're going to get more and more involved, of course, in all the specifics of how to design it, as well as, of course, some more of our basic understanding of villains. Class dismissed. Thank you for watching the GM Academy. You can click the video to see all of our classes on designing villains, and you can subscribe to get the latest information and videos from the GM Academy. If you enjoyed what you saw here, please hit the like button. It really does help us to continue to put out quality information to the community. Again, thank you for watching, and thank you for your support.